Now we have the symmetry of geometrical figures, but these geometrical figures are going to be the regular polygons. So regular polygons are those polygons, or you can say the closed figures that have all the sides equal to each other. So here we are going to discuss the regular polygons specifically, that is the figures that have all the sides equal. First we have the equilateral triangle. In equilateral triangle, all the three sides of this triangle are equal, that is AB is equal to BC is equal to CA. So what is the line symmetry for equilateral triangle? The line symmetry is 3. And what are those lines? The line segments joining midpoints with opposite vertex. These are the midpoints 2, 3. These are the three midpoints. The three midpoints are joined with the opposite vertex. That tells us the line symmetry for equilateral triangle. Point symmetry is the point where angle bisectors meet. These are actually the angle bisectors also for the case of equilateral triangle. That is, if you bisect angle A, if you bisect angle B, and if you bisect angle C, the point where all the three angle bisectors meet is the point of symmetry for equilateral triangle. Next we have the order. It has order 3. That means it can be rotated 3 times to get back the original state of this triangle. Next we have the square. Now square has 4 lines of symmetry. That is the line segments joining midpoints and the diagonals. Here we have the midpoints. This is the midpoint, the line segment joining midpoint, another line segment joining midpoint. We have diagonal 1 and diagonal 2. So in total we have 4 lines of symmetry for the case of square. What about the point of symmetry? The center of the square is known as the point of symmetry, and the order would be 4. That means it can be rotated 4 times to get back this square into its original position. Next we have the pentagon. Pentagon has all the 5 sides equal to each other, right? So what will be the line symmetry? It has 5 lines of symmetry. The lines are joining midpoints with the opposite vertex. The midpoint of this, let us name it first, A, B, C, D, E. Now it has 5 equal sides. Let us find out the midpoint. This is the midpoint of AE. This is the midpoint of AB, midpoint of BC, midpoint of CD, and midpoint of DE. So the lines joining midpoint with the opposite vertex are the lines that are lines of symmetry for pentagon. So it has 5 lines of symmetry. What about the point symmetry? It has no point symmetry and it has order 5. So now we can conclude that pentagon has 5 lines of symmetry without having any point symmetry, and the lines of symmetry additional to that, we have this rotational symmetry as 5. Next we have the hexagon. In hexagon we have the 6 lines of symmetry, and those lines are the lines joining midpoints and the diagonals. Here we have the midpoints of the hexagon. Because it has all the sides equal, it will have the midpoints also, right? And all the midpoints are joined with each other. The opposite midpoints are joined, and there are diagonals also to this. The diagonal means the lines joining opposite vertices. So the lines joining midpoints and lines joining opposite vertices are the lines of symmetry for hexagon. Point of symmetry for hexagon is the center of hexagon, and the rotational symmetry for hexagon is going to be 6, because it can be rotated 6 times to get back to its original position.